Interesting there, my breed, my choice. As part of growing its regional presence, Commercial Bank of Africa is betting on raising 8 billion shillings through the stock market to fund the bank's expansion strategy. The bank will be floating a medium-term note with an eye on setting up branches in Rwanda and Burundi in the next 5 years. At least 4 billion shillings will go towards regional expansion, with the other funds being deployed to financing their Kenyan operations. The push among indigenous banks to go regional continues to gather steam, with Commercial Bank of Africa announcing that it wants to widen its footprint. The bank will be looking to grow its revenue base and shield its local operation from weathering any aftershocks, the eventuality of a drop in profitability.
So the first countries we are looking at are Rwanda and Burundi. The second phase of the expansion will then bring in the countries which are bordering East Africa. With the plans we have in place, the idea is to ensure that in 10 years' time, we are actually operating in 16 markets.
According to CBA, the growth will be funded by a corporate bond to be floated at the Nairobi Securities Exchange. The bond will be repaid within 6 years and valued in Kenyan shillings.
For the bank, I think it provides us with a core funding from a tier two capital perspective, which we can use to support our investments in Kenya and in the region. I think the principal reason for anybody going regional is that we have a market which is then much, much bigger.
CBA joins the growing list of banks shoring up their capital ahead of the central bank's 2015 deadline. As a tier two bank, CBA is also looking to play with the big boys on the regional front to boost income. Banks with a regional presence generated $250 million in total revenues in 2013, which was a 13% year-on-year growth, a keen indicator as to why CBA is eyeing these markets. Other banks that have floated corporate bonds include CFC Stanbic, NIC and I&M. CBA will be sweating its assets to hit a balance sheet of 400 billion shillings by 2018, a figure that economists say is overly ambitious.